Welcome to the session, Data Structure, Stack, Gate Questions. The learning outcome is, at the end of this session, the student will be able to solve data structure stack problems. Pause the video and find out the answer. For this question only, we are using two knowledge of first is of stack and second is of queue. What is the stack? Stack is having two basic operations where we are inserting and deleting the any variables. Here we are calling that as push, which insert a data atom on the stack, and pop, which removes an atom from the top of the stack. So when we are pushing any atom, then second we are pushing. So whatever the data will be on that top of the stack, and when we are removing it, immediately whatever top of the stack that will be going to remove. So that will be last in, first out. So first in, first out, that is the wrong answer. Second, for the queue, we will see queue is having concept that whatever the elements we can access in the queue is in the first in, first out manner. That is, whatever we are entering data first, that will be coming out first. So as we can see, this last in, first out type of the computations are efficiently supported by queue is wrong answer, because it is a last in, first out is not the correct answer, but it is a first in, first out. So for this first and fourth, both are wrong answer. Wherever the first and fourth is mentioned, so all three options are wrong. So only the A, that is the correct answer. Now next question is, the following operations are performed on a stack: push 10, push 20, pop, push 10, push 20, pop, 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 push 20, pop. The sequence of the values popped out will be, this is the question of 1991. This also you can try to answer it. So we'll see the sequence. First we are going to push 10. So in this sequence we are pushing 10, then we are pushing 20, and then immediately we are popping that 20. Then next we are pushing 10, then pushing 20, then popping means 20, 10 and 10. So three pops will be there. And then next we are pushing 20 and immediately we are popping it. So last will be 20. So our sequence will be 20, 20, 10, 10, 20. So this answer is matching here, 20, 20, 10, 10, 20. So here B answer is matching over here. Now this is the third question. Assume that the operator plus, minus, multiplication are left associative and power is the right associative. The order of precedence from highest to lowest is power, multiplication, addition and minus. The postfix expression corresponding to the infix expression A plus B into C minus D raised to E raised to F will be, what will be the answer for this? So this is the infix operation, it is given, and we have to find out what will be the postfix operation matching to this operation. So this question is of 2004. So basically we'll see what is the infix expression. Here infix expression means when the operator is between two operand, that is operand, operator and operand, if it is in this sequence, then it is called as an infix expression. So your operator is infix. So for example, it is A plus B. What is the postfix expression? Postfix expression is when your operator is at the post place, means operand and operand, and then operator is there. At the end, if all the operators are there, then it is called as a postfix expression. Now in given question, we have to convert infix expression to postfix expression. Now in that case, we will be using stack and we will be pushing all the operators on the stack. So when converting infix to postfix, the stack will push all the operator on the stack. And reverse case, when we are converting postfix to infix with the stack, we have to push operands instead of operators here. Now we'll see the algorithm how to convert infix to postfix. So first push, here first we are pushing opening bracket and we are ending with closing bracket. So our stack will show first pushing of opening bracket, then we will scan. Here we have mentioned x and y. X is the infix expression and y is postfix expression, what will be converted after the conversion. So here let x is the arithmetic expression written in infix notation. The algorithm will find the equivalent of this postfix expression y, and we will be scanning it from left to right and then repeat the steps 3 to 6 for each element in the x until the stack is empty. Now what is the main operations will be here? If an operand is encountered, add directly to the y. Y means postfix expression. If we are finding any operand, then that operand will go to directly y. If a left parenthesis is encountered, we will pushing it on the stack. If an operator is encountered, then repeatedly we will be popping from the stack and add to y each operator which is the same precedence or higher precedence. Now means we will be popping any operator when it is having the same precedence or higher precedence than the operator. Then one more condition will be there, that if a right parenthesis is encountered, means here we have pushed a left parenthesis, and if we find the right parenthesis, then we will be repeatedly popping all the stack and add to the y each operator from the top of the stack until we are finding left parenthesis on the stack, and then we will be removing that left parenthesis from the stack. So this is the algorithm to convert. Mainly two operations are there. We are pushing the operator on the stack, and when we are popping it, when we are finding the same precedence or higher precedence than whatever we are scanning that operator. So your gate question is 3, which is given a plus b into c minus d power to e power to f. Now here first we will push this curly bracket, then we are having a will be directly going to the postfix expression, then plus is there, after that plus we are pushing that on the stack, b is there, b will be go to the postfix expression, then multiplication sign is there, multiplication sign is higher precedence than this addition, so it will be pushed on the stack. Then we are having C, so here A, B, C will be there, and then we are having scan sign is minus. Now minus sign is smaller precedence than whatever we are having in the stack, so we are popping this multiplication sign as well as addition sign. So here you can see that multiplication sign and addition sign will be popped. Now next after that is D is pushed, then D is added to the postfix expression, then power sign is there, power will be the higher precedence, so we are pushing to the stack, and then E is there, so that will go to the postfix expression. Then again we are having power. So here power and power sign will be the same precedence. So whatever in the stack and already we have scanned, so both will be having same precedence. Here we need to pop actually, but this second power sign is right associative. As it is right associative, so we are pushing that in the sequence and we are not popping anything. Then we are putting E, E is already there, and then F. After that, whatever the top of the stack, that will be popped. So both power will be popped, and lastly minus N. So our expression A plus B into C minus D power to E power to F will be converted ABC multiplication plus DEF power to minus. So there one more question is there. Which of the following is essential for converting an infix expression to postfix form efficiently? So options are an operator stack, an operand stack, an operand stack and operator stack, a parse tree. So just we have seen that we need a operator on the stack. So we have to push operators on the stack. So that is the correct answer. Thank you.